Hi everyone, Anthony Fantano here, internet's busiest music nerd. Hope you're doing well. And it is time for another edition of our Why You Know review, where I go over a series of records in brief, review them in short, gauntlet style, one after the next. It's what we do. That's the segment. You know what it is. At the end of this, we will link you to a playlist where you can see other Why You Know review videos. Here are my short takes on all of the records that I have decided to talk about in this episode. Ba-bam. I'm just not really sure what to say about this other than that it is maybe the most low energy and mindless trap record I've heard this year. I just do not hear the appeal of this. This is boring as hell. This is vapid. Like, nothing goes on here. Vocally, it's uninteresting. Instrumentally, it's uninteresting. Lyrically, it's repetitive. The flows are mind-numbing. It's boring. New Chromatics record. It's been a while since we've heard a new project, and there are a few cuts on this one that stood out to me. I appreciated the slightly more cinematic aesthetics and sound and tone of the project's particular approach to dream pop, but still can't say it's doing all that much for me. It's still a little too faint for my ears. But hey, if you're a dream pop fiend, give it a shot, give it a listen. It's not that bad. It's not bad at all. New 88 Rising compilation. I get that the point of this series is to make very summery, sweet, very commercial music, but I feel like that didn't need to come at the sacrifice of losing any and all personality that 88 Rising had going for them as a label, as a collective up until this point, because to my ears, this is just faceless pop music. This is just really faceless pop music and pop rap music, and there's very little of it that truly and honestly sticks out. For as mediocre as Head in the Clouds was at some points, like, at least the voices and the songs and the character of that project were memorable and showed potential and made you look forward to the future of what 88 Rising could be, potentially. And now it seems like they're just kind of throwing all of that out the window for something that can just slip, I guess, even more easily, just undetected into a generic playlist of summery pablum. Ugh. New Homeboy Sandman project. It's been a while since I've had any interest in a lot of what Sandman has done over the years, because I find his music and I find his delivery to be a little too underwhelming at points, but I do love how dusty and consistently lo-fi and out there a lot of the tracks on this record are. Occasionally funny too, if you're looking for a left-field rap record that is a little grimy, is kind of quiet, subdued, minimal, but above all else, dusty. Give it a shot. Give it a try. Kim Gordon of Sonic Youth fame really stepping out here with a big solo effort. There were some songs in the lead up to this project that I was pretty interested by, thought were some of the better teasers of the year, frankly. And now that I'm hearing the entire record, I think it's okay. I think it's decent. It's a little bit of a mess. It's kind of all over the place. There's not a lot of cohesion in the track list stylistically. There's a little dip in terms of songwriting quality at some points too. But I will say that consistently, Kim does drum up some really interesting sounds. You know, for an artist who's been around for as long as she has, it's intriguing to hear her embracing some of these elements of industrial music, at least newer sounds coming out of it at the moment. There's even a track on here where she is kind of doing her thing vocally over a trap beat. Not the best track on the album, but still. I love that she's embracing new ideas and sounds. She is applying most of them pretty well. And I'm just hoping to hear her maybe do all of this a bit more effectively on a more focused solo effort into the future. New record from the band Issues, which I have been seeing a lot of very, very wide and bold praise for. Even my dude Finn McKinty, like, loves the hell out of this project. Been seeing a lot of gent and metalcore and metalhead kids are freaking out over this one. I personally just don't see it or get the appeal. I mean, these heavy, slightly genty, slightly proggy guitars basically being matched up with very slick, clean, poppy lead vocals, almost the type of vocal that you would hear on top of a Maroon 5 song. And I'm just not really all that into the combination. I mean, I wasn't really into these elements and these sounds when they were in their own respective camps to begin with. And to hear them put together, to some people who are maybe, you know, just born in an era where these are their musical surroundings, this is their musical context, this is probably interesting and seems groundbreaking and seems exciting to hear metal and pop, at least current strains of it, come together in this way. For me personally, I'm not as much into it. Don't care for the vocals, don't care for the songwriting style, don't care for the guitar tones or the riff styles either. You know, call me old, call me over the hill, call me out of touch, but this is probably just not for me. New Summer Walker project. I've been seeing a lot of hype for this one that I think is somewhat well-deserved. I mean, Summer is a capable singer, and this new project of hers seems to be at least a little conceptual. I like that you have artists in the R&B field currently, maybe in part thanks to SZA getting a bit more thematic with some of the stuff they're coming out with. But I don't know, vocally, I just don't find this album that impressive. A lot of the songs underwhelm me, and above all else, I think the instrumentals are pretty bland. So, I mean, while I think Summer Walker does hit upon some good and ambitious ideas on this project, I'm just not really wowed by it from front to back. New Foals, the sequel to the album they dropped earlier this year. I think there are a few cuts on here that are a bit more rough, gruff, bombastic than many of the lighter and more spacey tracks off of the part one portion of this two record series. But in my opinion, a lot of the problems of the first record carry over onto the second as well. I'm not crazy about it, but if you loved the first, I can see why you would be into the second. New Nonstop SOPHIE remix album, a 90-minute project, really in two parts. I have been kind of sitting and waiting to get a minute to really sit down and digest this thing, as I just did not have the opportunity right away when it dropped. And I like that SOPHIE and her collaborators on this project come together with some pretty experimental mixes here and there. A good mix of deconstructed club and acid house and acid techno. It's very bold, it's very rigid, it's very all over the place. I can't say there are a whole lot of remixes here that I would rather listen to than the originals, and some of the remixes, especially one of the Ponyboy remixes in the first leg of the project, get a little obnoxious. Seem like they're trying too hard to be out there or kooky or zany. Still though, I do love the experimentation. I do love that non-stop continuous energy of the whole thing. And undoubtedly, this is one of the most ambitious remix projects of the decade. So that really can't be ignored either. Give it a try if you loved the new SOPHIE record. I'm not going completely bonkers for it, but I do think it's pretty good. The new Refused album, in my opinion, is even more difficult of a listen than the last one they just dropped. It's like some of the elements of post-hardcore from the band's past, which are really just melting off at this point, are being replaced by just like these really awful blends of punk rock and vague notions of rock and roll, and the riffs are corny, the vocals are corny, the production is mediocre. It's just really unfortunate to see one of the most wild and rambunctious and groundbreaking bands of the 2000s come to this end. Singer, songwriter, producer, Finneas, aka the brother of Miss Billie Eilish, has come through with a brand new EP. I think there are some decent tracks on it. The production or the songwriting, neither are really as out there or as memorable as many tracks off the Billie Eilish record that dropped not too long ago. And there are even some more organic, slightly more, I don't know, acoustic or piano-based cuts on this one that actually remind me of, like, I don't know, Ed Sheeran, and not in a way that I find to be all that interesting. I don't know. I mean, I think Finneas clearly has a lot of talent. I'm hoping just for a project at some point in the future that is at least as bold or as creative as what he typically does with his sister. To me, this batch of songs is very middling, very plain, very average, feels very lowest common denominator. It's definitely on some normie shit, and I don't know, I can't say it's all that impressive. New Yacht record. There were some tracks off of this one that I thought had great dance grooves, fun hooks, but it's consistently just not as bold vocally or songwriting-wise as I would have liked it to be. There are a lot of ideas in the deeper cuts of this record that I found to be just a little too faint, a little too, I guess, touch and go. Over the years, I have loved Yacht when they have truly shown themselves to be a very out there and a very creative and a very colorful musical duo. However, that attitude, that left field fringe, kind of odd attitude, I rarely find flows consistently throughout an entire project. And, you know, this is just kind of that same thing. We hit a point where the music and the performances just get really underwhelming, and that's unfortunate. Portico Quartet are back with a record that sees them returning to the spacey, groovy, linear, somewhat futuristic blend of jazz fusion that they kind of made a name for themselves on and detoured from for a little bit with a couple of projects that were not really all that fulfilling. And now that they're back in this gear, it's not bad. It's okay. I just wouldn't say it outdoes any of the great records from their past that are in the same style. But hey, if you were one of many listeners who were unhappy to hear the band make the shift in sound they did, you may be pleased to find that they're kind of, you know, just like back in a in their regular or their more familiar form, and it's sounding pretty decent. You know, there's something to be said about this album and its use of sex and sexuality. They often say in media, in music, whatever it may be, that sex sells. But I love that Brooke Candy pushes that notion to the point where sex no longer becomes commercial. It's so extreme, it's so raw, it's so raunchy, it's so in your face that there's absolutely nothing marketable about this album whatsoever. And that energy, those aspects of this album, I love. What I don't love about this record is that some of the vocal performances are just okay. Some of the beats are a little trashy, and ultimately there are tracks on this thing that feel very underwritten. Feels like they're just trying to deliver a very raw, raunchy, nasty sound and style and attitude, but the songwriting, the compositions kind of just fall to the wayside. Also, there are some features on this thing that are a little doo-doo, mostly the Iggy Azalea one. Love the idea, vision, and concept of what Brooke Candy is doing. Just think there are some ways that musically what she's doing could be improved. Rapper, singer, songwriter, father, back with a new EP, the Husband EP. And this project mostly sees Father heading in a direction where he's embracing more cloud rap aesthetics, more vocal melodies, more glitzy and glamorous synths. It's very pretty and almost like, you know, anime-like as the cover of this thing depicts over here. And there are some tracks on this thing that I enjoyed, but they're mostly the grimier ones, or the ones that have more personality, attitude, more of a tongue-in-cheek or funny demeanor. Mostly the Zach Fox track, or the track Handful. The other cuts I didn't really care for all that much, but I guess I'll say that if this is your thing, if this is your sound, if this is your vibe, I think Father does it just as well, if not better, than many other artists out there shooting for a similar thing. I mean, I would rather listen to this than any number of Drain Gang releases, if that's an apt comparison. Zishan, have you given any of these albums a listen? Did you love them? Did you hate them? What would you rate them? You're the best, you're the best. What should I review next? Hit the like if you like. Please subscribe and please don't cry. Hit the bell as well. Over here next to my head is another video for you to check out. Hit that up or the link to subscribe to the channel. Anthony Fantano, YUNOREVIEW, forever.